Have you ever tried meditation, struggling hard to concentrate and keeping your mind as blank as a whitewashed wall by closing your eyes, nose, ears, and shutting out every possible thought, everything, and the only failure that ever came, the only gross betrayal was from your own skin. You will have known this. Do you still remember how the first distractions arose and you blamed skin as a sinner? How when your kundalini was rising, shaken. How, when your kundalini was rising, you were shaken. You felt the cold concrete floor, skin rubbing against skin. Your saffron robes, how, even in a far off different realm, your skin anchored you to this earth. And here we have a full stop. Now, we understand till now, the poet is questioning or interrogating, and she is asking the fundamental question. Those who say that human can transcend the body, and those who claim the yogis or people who wear saffron robes, they claim that they can whitewash their minds. They claim that they can shut off their ears, they can shut off their eyes. And that means they can separate their body from their soul or from their mind. So she is asking, did that happen? Were there distractions that betrayed you? So are your own skin betrayed you. So why don't you talk about the betrayals which happened, and the body betrays you? Why? Because body is not the way you tell us, the way you describe us. The body is an instrument. It is a system of sensors. The body is made up of sensors. The sensors are in the ear, in the nose, in the tongue, on the skin, in the eyes. Everywhere there are sensors around us. So is it possible to transcend those sensors and then be there? So the poem entitled Touch is raising the philosophical question, and that too which is very popular in the form of yoga or spirituality or religion. Now she is saying that when your kundalini was rising, some yogi or some people who wear saffron robes or who claim to have transcended their bodies and who have reached to the height of the Sadda Chitta Ananda, the extreme form of Ananda, those who claim that, they claim that their kundalini has awakened. Kundalini is a term in the yoga. When the energy rises from the below and reaches to the up, the top of the, so it's a kind of theory in the yoga. But she is asking, did your skin anchor you? I mean, how did you realize that Kundalini Jagran, Kundalini awakening, did you realize it by the thrill in your body, by the sensations in your nervous system? So if that happened because of sensation, because of skin, because of this kind of experience, then how did you free yourself from the body? Could you shut your nervous system off? Okay. Now, this poem therefore begins at this note, and we will see the flight or the trajectory of the poem. Amidst all that pervading emptiness, so now she is taking it when the Kundalini awoke. So amidst all that pervading emptiness, touch retained its sensuality. So there was emptiness, but touch is the thing that informs you that you are there as a sensor. That is, touch is not only a feeling, but it is information, and it is also a gate that let something come in. Okay, so touch retained its sensuality. Touch retained its body, its sensuality, physicalness. Okay, now you will have known this, and or if you thought more variedly about taste, you would discount it as the touch of the tongue. Now she is shifting from one touch, one sense to other senses. Or if you thought more variedly about taste, you would discount it, and you would say, no, what is the need of it? As the touch of the tongue, now the touch of the tongue. Okay, so touch of the tongue. This is interesting phrase. Why? Because tongue is to taste. We don't, but the tongue touches something, and then the gate opens. Okay, the window opens. Or you may recollect. Now one can imagine what are those activities, and what are those cultural practices, what are those rituals, and what are those areas where tongue is used to create this sensation. Or you may recollect how a gentle touch, a caress, changed your life multifold. Now this is the cathartic area where catharsis starts coming in a poetic language. Okay, now how a gentle touch, a caress, changed your life multifold, and you were never the person you should have been. Now how a touch can transform you totally. Okay, so touch, which you discount or which you think should not be utilized or which should be discarded because you cannot become a spiritual person or you cannot reach to the height of your soul unless you transcend your body. So she says that what you are doing through all these rituals, by not accepting the body, by not accepting the body, which is the basis of your entire existence, and all the windows to the world open through the body, through these senses. And one touch sometimes transforms your entire experience, your entire... So she says that it is a transformation. It is not whitewashing. It is not whitewashing the mind and then cleaning it and then saying that it does not exist. He says that any material that we have can be transformed. So transformation is the idea. Touch can do the same thing which any other thing can do it. And you were never the person you should have been. Feeling with your skin was perhaps the first of the senses. And feeling with your skin was perhaps the first of your senses. So feeling with skin, yes, it was the first of the senses because in the womb of mother, what is there? You have a body and the skin is in touch with. Rest of the things are not there. No language, no mathematics, no religion, no rituals, no festivals, no name, no caste, no gender, nothing. What is skin? So skin is the only and only source of information. And that is the first primal gate of learning, the skin, okay, which we think is of no use in our new journey of spirituality. So so the person you have been feeling with your skin was perhaps the first of the senses. Its reality always remained with you. So when you came out from your mother's womb in the environment, you experienced the environment, not through words, not through images, not through other things, but the skin sensed everything, whatever temperature or whatever, you know. And your response then was that you give the first voice, the cry or anything, you know. And then everybody is happy that a child is born. So each one of the attendant at the at a delivery room expects that the baby should immediately cry. Okay, why? Because that informs that she is or he is alive. Okay, so it's the skin, it's your presence there, the body that senses the environment, and you find, is it a strange environment, stranger that earlier you were there in the womb for 9 months and now you are in the another big womb of the earth, okay, and you feel restless for some time. So feeling with your skin was perhaps the first of the senses. Its reality always remained with you and you never got rid of it. And you can't get rid of that reality. Even if you have forgotten what is there in the mind, you will have known this. You will have known almost every knowledgeable thing about the charms and the temptation that touch could hold. So touch, therefore, is the most intelligent, most knowledgeable and most transformative faculty. So now she is raising the word touch to the poetic level, to the sublime level, okay, which has been neglected. So in the beginning, we see touch has been put aside, being discarded or not entertained. And then she keeps on writing in that language, poetic language. And then the bird suddenly starts flying. You know, after all, a poem is a bird's flight. And touch here now is rising up and touching the sky, that you will have known almost every knowledgeable thing about the charms and temptation that touch could hold, but you will never have known that touch. But now she is taking the other, diving into the sky. And when we are at the top in the feeling of touch, she tells you suddenly something very different, which we have developed as a caste society. The idea of touch, the idea of untouchability, the idea of a classification about touch, about this feeling, which is categorized, okay? Which categorize the skin, this skin can be touched and this skin cannot be touched. This skin is polluting, this skin is black, this skin is white, this skin is, you know, so all that knowledge system that you have, which further make the touch impossible. But you will have never known that touch, the taboo, the myth that has been put under the carpet or which cannot be talked about, okay, to your transcendence, which when crystallizes in caste. So you see, when you transcend, what you leave behind your touch. When your soul becomes free from your body, what you leave behind your body, your touch. And then we recognize it, this body had created another domain which defined other bodies as untouchable. So to your transcendence, when crystallized in caste, what a paraphernalia of undeserving hate. And that is a paraphernalia, that is the kit. It's a kit of tools with which you can cause hate to the undeserving. I mean, somebody doesn't deserve to be hated just because you think that the skin you have is untouchable. And that paraphernalia which you have in your mind, those tools, maybe rituals or maybe shastras, maybe belief system, maybe the superiority complex of being upper caste or being purer person, all of that paraphernalia is in your mind. You think you have transcended it and you have reached to a new height of soul, but what you have left behind is a burden for us, okay, for the Dalits or for the people who are considered low caste in the caste hierarchy, which defines bodies and minds in a stratified way, in an unequal manner.